our environment was loose, so it was easy for me to tell my stories. I can't, like, I'm not a rapper that could just sit there and say, riding in my Bentley, cruising in my Rolls Royce, because I don't have those things. You will hear me rapping about things that I have and things that I've been through. It's like, and some of the shit that I've been through by the time I was 13 years old, it's grown men that's 40 years old, it's 80-year-olds that's on their deathbed that haven't been through it. And now that I'm older, I see it like it was all part of a plan for me to tell my story, because I've been through so much shit, but the way I rap, I need that shit. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I need the shit that happened to me. All, even the worst shit that felt fucking horrible, I need that shit so I could tell it to the world. Or I can make sure that somebody else isn't, that's in the same exact situation or something similar, or even any situation that can relate at all, can realize, yo, somebody else has been through this. I don't have to feel this way. Like, because, like, you know, I believe a lot in vibes. Like, if I was sitting around with a fucking miserable mood all day around you and shit, then you would probably come back here to the studio a little grouchy. You know what I mean? It's contagious. If I'm happy and we laugh and we joke all day, you're gonna come back in this motherfucker laughing and joking for the rest of the day. I don't want, like, to compare my situation to anybody's. It's not like my situation is better, I know, or any worse or any better than anybody else's. I know there's somebody sitting way nicer than I am, and I know somebody sitting way worse than I am. So, I mean, for that, that's a blessing in itself, you know?